Hi, my name is Leonardo Murillo, and I build cool stuff in AWS using products in AWS Marketplace. Thank you for joining me. We're going to be talking about industry trends, challenges, and how you can solve them. Today, I want to talk about the rise of platform engineering and how Kubernetes and cluster observability are now daily concerns across the whole IT organization. Some trends have historically been driven by the wide-reaching transformation that adopting DevOps started to fuel years back. Promoting collaboration and the you own it, you build it axiom were a major push for team autonomy. Because teams started to own infrastructure and became empowered to make all sorts of decisions from tech stack to architecture. It was all great. Teams were shipping faster. Value was getting to customers faster. But there were a couple of caveats. On the one hand, teams were suddenly exposed to a whole new domain of complexity and subject matter expertise. Many of them were not quite comfortable with it. And on the other, that very dramatic change that happens sometimes without a set of guiding principles or an overarching standard resulted in massive diversity. And problems started to arise from that diversity, from difficulty related to operations to duplication of efforts, skyrocketing cloud costs, and what I call poor developer portability, because everything was being built slightly differently. So moving across teams became difficult and exposed developers to a steep learning curve. And these are just some of the reasons why platform engineering came into the spotlight. Because platform engineering promises to keep teams autonomous and capable of self-service, but providing them with templated offerings that embedded best practices and that provided a common ground to get things done faster, but sharing enough similarities so that developers could move around and still feel comfortable. Now, we also got to talk about application runtime environments, because together with this transformation we just talked about, containers and container orchestration also became the norm for the majority of development teams out there. And as most of you know, Kubernetes also became the de facto standard for container orchestration. Kubernetes really took the world by storm. And the challenge here is that teams started to spin up their own clusters, or organizations started to deploy cluster fleets for all sorts of at-scale use cases, like edge and IoT and other similar scenarios. And the thing is that Kubernetes is not simple. So every team had to go and figure it out. And therefore, Kubernetes turned into a key offering in the service catalog for most internal developer platforms that are being built by platform engineering teams. And what is indispensable in any Kubernetes offering? Observability. Because being able to understand how applications are running is a critical capability that all autonomous teams really must have. So this is where EKS, with EKS add-ons, together with some like the Grafana Cloud Kubernetes Monitoring EKS add-on that you can get off AWS Marketplace, tied together with something like, say, CDK, the Cloud Development Kit, allow platform engineering teams to offer, with just a few lines of code, fully observable Kubernetes as part of their IDP. Now, with AWS Marketplace EKS add-on from Grafana Cloud, you get all the components that you need for your cluster to start shipping telemetry to Grafana Cloud instantly deployed. And since you can program all that into a parameterizable template written with CDK, it can very easily become part of your EKS-based Kubernetes offering in your IDP. Now, where it gets even cooler is when you look at dashboards and alerts as being part of that offering, because Grafana Cloud already offers a full set of dashboards for teams to have a complete and comprehensive understanding of their clusters right out of the box. And for every other custom need, Grafana Cloud supports native JSON declarative dashboard configuration, so you can integrate those into your Kubernetes offering as well. And again, thinking along the lines of a CDK solution, right? You can just embed and configure Kubernetes dashboards and alerts automatically as part of the Kubernetes offering that your developers are getting from your service catalog. So what you get is fully automated, observable Kubernetes, following best practices using one of the more preferred Kubernetes distributions available, EKS. So look for the technical article that comes with this video and get a closer view into how this is actually done with code. Be on the lookout for a lab that we're going to be releasing soon, where I'm going to be walking you step by step to actually building a solution like this on your own. See you all soon.